differences between classical conditioning and operant conditioning. Session outline, we'll have first introduction to classical and operant conditioning and then differences between classical and operant conditioning. At the end of this module, you will be able to explain classical conditioning and operant conditioning, differentiate between classical and operant conditioning. Hi students, we have already learnt about classical and operant conditioning. Just to revise, classical conditioning is a process of stimulus substitution after association, and the subject is passive, learning is reflex action, whereas in operant conditioning, the subject is active and it is a process of response modification through selective reinforcement. Though there are four processes which are common to both kind of conditioning, there are stark differences between operant conditioning and classical conditioning. Let us know about them in this particular session. Classical conditioning is known as S-type theory, because we always emphasize on the stimulus, how to present natural stimulus with the neutral stimulus. So the focus will be on manipulation of the situation. Hence, classical conditioning is called S-type theory. It was propounded by Ivan Pavlov. Operant conditioning is also known as R-type theory, as we always focus on the response. How to take the response towards desired behavior through selective reinforcement. So response modification is the focus. It was propounded by B.F. Skinner. In classical conditioning, the subject is passive. The reinforcing stimulus food is given before the response. It doesn't come as a reward. It is given irrespective of the response by the organism. Whereas in operant conditioning, the subject is active. The reinforcing stimulus food comes only after a desired response in the form of reinforcement. In classical conditioning, the experimenter wants to build an association in the mind of the organism between natural stimulus and neutral stimulus. Natural stimulus you see as food and neutral stimulus see as bell, using the law of contiguity. Contiguity means nearness. So the experimenter presents both together so that the organism can form an association between the two. In operant conditioning, an association is formed between the response and the reinforcement using the law of effect. So here the experimenter would be waiting to find out which response should be given, which reinforcement. So here reinforcement will be a consequence of a particular response. So we call that as the law of effect being used. The essence of classical conditioning is stimulus association first and then substitution of the natural stimulus by the neutral stimulus. So the process is called stimulus association and substitution. Whereas operant conditioning is a process of response modification through selective reinforcement. In classical conditioning, autonomous nervous system is involved and the responses are all involuntary reflex actions. The organism is not consciously making any responses. Just because a particular situation is presented, the reflex actions automatically respond. In operant conditioning, on the contrary, the organism consciously moves towards the desired behavior defined by the experimenter, as it is controlled by central nervous system. All our likes, dislikes, anxieties, fears, and superstitions are the result of classical conditioning. Whereas the various aspects of our personality, our interests, habits, attitudes are the result of operant conditioning. To summarize, Classical conditioning and operant conditioning both are behaviorist theories. In both, learning is gradual. Learning is a process of habit formation. But there are some differences between the two. Classical conditioning is called S-type theory because the focus is on stimulus, whereas operant conditioning is R-type theory because the focus is on response modification. In classical conditioning, the subject is passive. In operant conditioning, the subject is active. In classical conditioning, we present the food even before the organism gives a desired response. Whereas in operant conditioning, the food comes only as a reward for a particular response. In classical conditioning, we try to manipulate the situation by associating the two stimuli, UCS and CS, through the process of contiguity in time. Whereas in case of operant conditioning, we try to bring in the mind of the organism an association between the response and the reinforcement through the law of effect. In classical conditioning, all are reflex actions because it is governed by autonomous nervous system. Whereas in operant conditioning, conscious effort has to be made by the organism to give a particular behavior so as to get the reward because it is controlled by central nervous system. Thus, we see that all our likes, dislikes, fears, superstitions are because of classical conditioning, whereas in operant conditioning, our attitudes, values, interests, which have been shaped over a period of time, they are all the result of operant conditioning. Thank you.